Hello, children. The name of the chapter is Playing with Number. Many of you are very much more practicing maths. So this chapter, little you can play with number. So that. So I have written few sums. Yeah. It is written some in place of digit, some letter used. So what will be the letter that you have to take out by your own? Logically, you have to think and you have to find out. So that way, if you think, then logically you will improve your power. So now here you see it. It is given addition. Now a plus 7 equals to 2 given. So I have written on observing what I have written. A plus 7 should be 2. But with 7, what number you have to get? Because of 2 is less than 7. So if I take here 5, then it will become 12. So 1 carry, then 5 in case of A. If I put this part is 5, then it will become 12. Then 2 and 1 carry here. 1 carry on 10's place. So with A, you have to carry 1. So it will become 9, and now already I have taken A equals to 5. So 9 plus 5, then it will become 14. So 9 plus 5, it will become 14. Now B also unknown here. So this part to match with this number, I have taken at first A equals to 5. So here also I have written 5 and 1 carry, because 12 comes sum. Then 1 carry, so 8 plus 1, 9, 9 plus 5, 14, 4 in place of B, you have to write 4, and 1 carry 100 place, so 100 place this number will be 2 and B already 4. So 2 plus 4, then C value, we shall get 6. So children, here to solve, you have to manipulate, you have to think that which number you have to given number. These two number is given, so this number is not given, so you have to take such a number so that this number will match, some the number match. So this number A equals to 5 taken, so 2 comes, 1 carry, 9, then 5, then 9, 5, 14, 4 comes in place of B, then 4 if you put, 1 carry, so C comes 6. So you can solve A equals to 5, B equals to 4, C equals to 6. In that way, many addition you can solve. Now another multiplication I am going to explain you. So in that way you can solve subtraction and multiplication, division, this one. So I am going to explain now multiplication. In case of multiplication, 2a and 3a written, and product value also it is written here. So here think that a into a is equals to a written. So children, if a value is 1, then 1 into 1 means 1, because here also same value we have to take. 2 into 2, 4 comes, so that 2 we can take. 3 into 3, 9 comes, so we can take 3. 4 into 4, 16 comes, so we can take. 5 into 5, 25, so we can take 5 also. And 6 into 6, 36, so we can take 6 also. So children, A into A, possibility of A, 1, 5, 6. So if I take 1 after multiplying, if I take 1, here also 1. After multiplying, I found that this number already given, this number is not matching in my product. Here getting 5, and in that case it is coming 7. So here we have to take another number, 5. If 5 if you take, then exactly we are getting product 7, and there also it is given 7, so it is matching. It means this is the correct answer. So we are getting that k equals to 5 and b equals to 8. B value is 8, because after multiplying what product comes, then by 5 if you take 125, then 35, then 75, 25 into 3 and 75. After adding, we shall get 875. So B place 8 and A place 5. So answer A equals to 5 and B equals to A. So children, in that way, several sums you can solve. Now I shall discuss some divisibility test. So in general form, two digit number, as earlier video I have explained you that two digit number we can write 10A plus B 4. So if it is divisibility test, we have to find that by which number, how we can test that whether the given number is divisible or not. So here the two digit number 10A plus B 4. So 10A is multiple of 10. So this part is divisible by 10. Now we have to think that then what will be the number so that the two digit number will be divisible. What is the number of B? Then B number, B should be 0. Then only this two digit number will be divisible by 10. So children, then in case of divisibility test, you know that last digit of the number should be 0. Next, divisibility test for 5. In that case also, two digit number 10A plus B, that number 10A plus B, it is divisible by 5 or not, that what number of B we have to get. The 10A is also divisible by 5. So what number of B we can take so that the given number is divisible by 5. So B should be either it will be 0 or 5. Then that number, two digit number, will be divisible by 5. So divisibility test of 10 last digit means if you write 1050, the last digit is 0. So this number, whole number is divisible by 10 and also divisible by 5. But this number is divisible by 5. Why? Because last digit is 0. If last digit is 5, then this number is also divisible by 5. But what is the difference? This number is not divisible by 10, this number is divisible by 5, and this number is also divisible by 5, but this number is only divisible by 10. This is not divisible by 10 because in the divisibility test of 10, last digit only 0. But in case of 5, last digit 0 also, 5 also. So this is the divisibility test of 5 and 10. Now, divisibility test of 2. If the two digit number you are writing, two digit number, then this number 5a into 2 means this is divisible by 2, this number. Now which number will be B so that it is divisible by 2? So B either it is 0, 2, 4, then this number is divisible by 2. So divisibility test of 2 means last digit of the given number should be even number. So it can be 0, even number. If I write even number, so this is the divisibility test of 2. So whether the given number is divisible by 2 or not, we have to check the unit place digit. Unit place digit is even number. Then even number means, children, you know already, even number means 0, 2, 4, 6, like that way. The unit place, you have to check that whether the number is even number, that is divisible by 2. In case of divisibility rule of, and you can check by the generalized form also. But directly, it is very easy, only 2 marks. How it is coming, that numbers that you can read thoroughly your book. Now, next is divisibility test of 3. Divisibility test of 3. As you know that, divisibility test of 3 means sum of the digit here. This is the number I have written. Then if sum if you take, there are 3-digit number I have written. But in case of 2-digit number, if 2-digit number 24, then 24 sum of the 2-digit A and B, then 6. 6 is divisible by 3. So the given number is divisible by 3. When the sum of the digit of the given number is divisible by 3, then the whole number is divisible by 3. This is the divisibility test of 3. Now, say how you can take in the generalized form divisibility test of 3? Then 9a plus a plus b. So 9a plus a plus b you can write. So 9a is divisible by 3. And then a plus b, to make this number is divisible, what you have to do? You have to find the sum of the digit of the given number. Sum of the digit of the given number. So divisibility test of 3. Now divisibility test of 4. In case of divisibility test of 4, in case of 4, if this is the number, 3-digit number, last 2-digit is divisible by 4. This number divisible by 4, last 2-digit, 1's place digit and 10's place digit is divisible by 4, then the given number is divisible by 4. But in that case, is it divisible by 4? No, this number, last 2-digit, is not divisible by 4. So in that case, this is not divisible by 4. So children, divisibility test of 4 means when last, in the given number, last 2-digit is divisible by 4, then the whole number is divisible by 4. But last 2-digit is not divisible by 4, then the given number is not divisible by 4. And about 5 already discussed. In case of 6, 6 is the factor of 2 and 3. 6 is the factor of 2 and 3. So the number should be divisible by 2 also, which I have already explained, and also divisible by 3. Then the given number is divisible by 6. But if the number is divisible by 2 but not by 3, or if the number is divisible by 3 but not by 2, in that case it is not divisible by 6. We have to check the number should be divisible by 2 and 3. Then the given number is divisible by 6. Now in case of 7, how we have to check in case of 7? In case of 7, suppose I am writing 249579. So this is a number I have written. 72. Suppose I have written this number. Now this is 3 number together we have to take. Now this another part. And this is another part, but though there is only 2-digit is there. Now we have to add all these, this alternative block we have to add. This part and that part we have to add. Again, if it is larger number, bigger number, then this part and another part, if it is there, then that part we have to add, and then we have to find the difference. Now, after adding, what comes? 792 plus 24 we have to do. 996 and 957. Now, this number, no other number is there to add, but here there is a single block is there, so we have to take this properly and then we have to subtract. Then after adding, then again we have to subtract. Then difference is not divisible by 7. Difference is not divisible by 7. This is not divisible by 7. So the given number is not divisible by 7. So the given number is not divisible. So children, what I have done? This number, this one of the number I have just written. And then you take 3-digit. But 3-digit, then again 3-digit, Then again, 3 digits is not visible there, so this block you have taken. So these two part you have to leaving one block. This is one part way there. So leaving this part. So alternative part you have to add. That after adding we are getting this part. Okay. Then this part and that part after adding we are getting this number. And then this number, what are the remaining block and no other block is there to add. So only the single block is there, we have to subtract. Then after subtracting, we are getting 39, which is not divisible by 7. So given number is not divisible by 7. In case of 8, if the last 3 digit is divisible by, of the divisible by 8, then the whole number is divisible by 8. Last 3 digits, like that, last 3 digits, if it is divisible by 8, then the whole number is divisible by 8. Then, is it the number divisible by 8? Then, 1 divided by 8, then it will not come. 1 time 17, then 16, then 12, no, it is not divisible. So, it is not divisible by 8, this number, last 3 digits is not divisible by 8, so the given number is not divisible by 8. Now in case of 9, same way, that you have to add all the digit of the given number. If the sum of the digit is divisible by 9, then the whole number is divisible by 9, like this, because of this form it will come. If it is divisible by this part, is divisible by 9. And then sum. If sum of the digit of the given number is divisible by 9, then the whole number is divisible by 9. In case of 10, I have explained. In case of 11, suppose that question, that part only, in case of 11, how to solve, that I am explaining you. How to solve. Now children, from the right side, if you mark 1, 2, 3, 4, then 1 is odd number. So odd place, odd place, odd place, odd place. How? 1, 2, 3. So 1 odd place, 3, 5, 7. This all odd place number I have given. Even number. Even, 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 even. Now, sum of the odd place number you add. 2 plus 9. 2 plus 9 plus 5. 2 plus 9 plus 5 plus 4. 2 plus 9 plus 5 plus 4. Then what comes? 20 comes. 20 comes. Now even place, 7 plus 7 plus 9 plus 2. Then 25. Then their difference. This is with statement you have to write. You have to write that sum of the digit occupying the odd place, sum of the digit occupying even place. Their sum we are getting and then difference. Then difference. What is the difference come? 5. Difference comes 5. So 5 is not divisible by 11. So the given number is not divisible by 11. So children, 2 divide by 11, that difference should be 0 or multiple of 11. 0 or multiple of 11. So children, from 2 onward till 11, all the digit divisibility test I have explained thoroughly. So you go through the video and try to understand and solve by your own. So children, thank you.